So next topic is neat applications related to reflection of light. Neat applications. Neat applications related to reflection of light by plane wave. Now, so the law of reflection of light represented in vector form. So first one, laws of reflection of light in vector form. Laws of reflection of light in vector form. So the incident ray having the direction and also the reflected ray having the direction. So we can represent the law of reflection of light in vector form. Now let us consider a plane mirror whose one surface is reflecting and the other surface is opaque. This shaded part is opaque. This shaded part is there. It is called opaque surface. And this surface is a reflecting surface because at this surface reflection of light takes place. If the light incident on the plane mirror obliquely, the light turned back into the same medium obliquely. So it is called reflection of light. Now this point is called point of incidence because at this point light is incident. That is why this point is called point of incidence. Now it is incident ray. And it is reflected ray. So by knowing the directions, by knowing the LMR, we can say which is incident ray and which is reflected ray. So here this ray is towards the mirror means it is incident ray, and this ray is away from the mirror means it is reflected ray because it is turned back ray. Then now we are going to draw a perpendicular line at the point of incidence to the reflecting surface. Already you know that what is this? It is called normal. So it is normal. And already this is, you know about this one, this is incident ray by knowing the direction and it is a reflected ray. So we can represent the incident ray and reflected ray by using unit vector. So the unit vector taken along the incident ray is E1 and the unit vector taken along the reflected ray is E2. So what is the unit vector taken along the incident ray here? That is E1. So that unit vector can be resolved into two components. Then it is angle of incidence theta and it is angle of reflection, it is also theta. Angle of incidence theta and it is angle of reflection theta because angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So what is the alternate angle here? Here this is the alternate angle. So this is unit vector E1. This unit vector is taken along incident ray because this unit vector shows the direction. Okay, and its magnitude is how much? 1. Then E1 can be resolved into how many components here? Because E1 is in the xy plane. So which xy plane here? This is in positive x and negative y plane. Positive x and negative y plane. Positive x and negative y plane. So this unit vector E1 can be resolved into two components. So this component is taken as y component. The magnitude of unit vector into cos theta. So why it is E1 into cos theta here? Because here this side is adjacent for theta and this side is opposite for theta. See here, if I will draw the line from here, this side equal to this side means for this theta it is opposite side. Then what is this one? It is magnitude of E1 into sin theta. Okay, what is the component of unit vector E1 along the x-axis? That is magnitude of E1 into sin theta. The component of E1 along the y-axis, that is magnitude of E1 into cos theta. Already you know about resolution of vectors in first unit. Okay, you studied about resolution of vector in first unit. And also here E2. E2 is the unit vector taken along the reflected ray. This can be resolved into how many components here? Again, this can be resolved into two components. Then this angle, I will take theta. It is theta because these are corresponding angles. These are corresponding angle and these are alternate angles. Then what is the? It is y component and it is x component. What is y component of E2 here? That is magnitude of E2 into cos theta. Why? Because here, so this y component is adjacent for the theta, adjacent side for the theta, and this x component is opposite side to the theta. We can write magnitude of E2 into sin theta. So this is about resolution of vector. So why the unit vectors are resolved here? The unit vectors are resolved because of they are in xy plane. So E2 is in positive x and positive y plane, but E1 is in positive x and negative y plane. So what is E1? E1 can be taken as, E1 is the unit vector taken along the incident ray. That can be written as the vector is equal to the sum of components of the vector. So what are the sum of components of the vector? What are the components of the given vector here? What are the components of E1? That is E1 sin theta and E1 cos theta. So we can write magnitude of E1 sin theta. Here E1 sin theta is along positive x axis. We are going to take unit vector I. That unit vector I, then plus the y component of the E1. What is the y component of the E1? That is magnitude of E1 into cos theta. Magnitude of E1 into cos theta. So what is the unit vector taken along the negative y axis? That is minus j. Okay, it is minus j. We can write this one as, so magnitude of E1 is 1, because magnitude of unit vector is 1. What is the use of unit vector in the vector in the diagram? So that represents the direction of incident ray and that represents the direction of reflected ray. Magnitude of unit vector is how much? 1, that is sin theta I. So what unit vector I indicate here? What is the x component of E1 here? In which direction x component of the E1? In which direction x component of E1? In the positive x direction. Then next, plus into minus, minus. Then what is the magnitude of E1 again? That is 1. So cos theta, it is the y component of the E1. So y component of the E1 is along negative y axis. That is represented by unit vector minus j. Okay, it is E1. Then what about E2? E2 is that it is the unit vector taken along the reflected ray. Then what is the unit vector taken along the reflected ray? That is E2. Then E2 is equal to the x component of E2 plus the y component of E2. What is the x component of E2? That is magnitude of E2 into cos theta. It is along positive x axis. See here. It is along positive x axis and it is along positive y axis. So it is x component and it is y component. If it is x component of E2 is along positive x direction, means we have to take unit vector plus I. That is I. And y component of the E2. What is the y component of the E2? That is magnitude of E2 into cos theta. It is along positive y axis, means unit vector is taken as plus j. So magnitude of E2 into sin theta, unit vector is taken j. Then what is magnitude of unit vector again? 1 is, sorry, it is sin theta. It is sin theta I, because x component we are going to take here, and it is cos theta j. It is cos theta j. Then it is E2. What is the magnitude of E2 here? 1, that is sin theta I, and it is cos theta j. Then we are going to take the resultant of E1 and E2. What is the resultant of E1 and E2 here? So E1 in this direction and E2 is in this direction. It is E2 and it is E1. Then what is the resultant of these two here? So resultant of these two means we have to use parallelogram law of tradition method. What is the parallelogram law of retardation with the tail? So we have to join the tails of the two vectors. Okay, so means we have to take the negative vector of e1. Negative vector of e1. Negative vector of e1 means it is in the opposite direction of e1. It is the negative vector of e1. And it is the positive vector of e2. Then tail to tail join by using parallelogram law of retardation method. What is the parallelogram law of retardation method? You have to draw the parallel line from head of the e1 to the e2. Then you have to draw the parallel line from head of the e2 to the e1. These two parallel lines meet at a point. This point is called intersection point. Join the initial point and intersection point, we will get resultant of these two. Okay, by the law of retardation method, what is the, sorry, by the parallelogram law of retardation method, what is that? E2 minus E1. Okay, because one vector is positive and another vector is negative, we can write E2 minus of E1 is equal to, what about E2 minus E1? We have to subtract E2 and E1. So here it is E1 and it is E2. So it is a plus sin theta r. Now it becomes minus because minus is there. We can write sin theta r plus cos theta j. It is E2. Then minus sin theta r. And here, what is this one? Minus into minus, that is plus cos theta j. Then first term and third term get cancelled because they having same magnitude but they having opposite signs, they get cancelled. Then what left now? 2 cos theta j means here the resultant of e1 and e2 is taken along the normal. See here, this is the normal. The resultant of E1 and E2 is taken along the normal. Okay. So, normal means the unit vector taken along the normal can be taken as n cap. So, that is 2 cos theta n. So, j cap means here n cap because normal is along the y axis. Which axis here? Positive y axis. That is why instead of j, I will take n. What is n cap here? It is the unit vector taken along the normal. Then it is E2 minus of E1. Then what is cos theta here? Cos theta is that, it is, we are going to find the cos theta now. The projection of E1 on normal unit vector. The projection of E1 on normal unit vector. Okay, how to write that one? By using dot product. Minus of E1 dot n cap. The projection of negative unit vector taken along the incident ray on the normal unit vector, that is minus of E1 dot n cap, that is equal to magnitude of E1 into magnitude of n cap, then cos theta. What is magnitude of unit vector taken along the incident ray? That is 1, because magnitude of unit vector is always 1. And what is the magnitude of unit vector taken along the normal? That is also 1. Into cos theta. 1 into 1, that is 1. 1 into cos theta, that is cos theta. Then what is cos theta here? Cos theta is that minus of E1 dot n. Okay. So I will write here. That is minus of 2 E1 dot n. If the unit vector here, already n is there. Then it is E2 minus of E1. It is the vector representation of law of reflection of light. And also we can write this one as E2 is equal to, I will take minus E1 to the right hand side, that becomes plus E1. Plus E1 minus 2 E dot N N. Okay, it is the representation of law of reflection of light in vector form. Okay. Then what is E2 here? It is unit vector taken along the reflected ray. What is E1 here? It is unit vector taken along the incident ray. Then, so this is about law of reflection of light, and it is related to NEET. Okay, so it is not belongs to your theory. It belongs to only NEET application. You just go through this formula and how this one came already derived here. Okay.